lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day.
He's a lumberjack and he's okay. He sleeps all night and he works all day.
I cut down trees, I eat my lunch, I go to the lavatory. On Wednesdays I go shopping and have bottom scones for tea.
He cuts down trees, he eats his lunch, he goes to the lavatory. On Wednesdays he goes shopping and his butter scones for tea.
I'm a lumberjack and I'm okay. I sleep all night and I work all day. I cut down trees, I skip and jump, I like to press one.
It's on! Is this good enough? Should
back
I hold
up,
it higher?
Maybe just a step.
Oh my god. Is this
all
better?
Right. Yeah, that's perfect. Hi, this is Chris, Chris of the Tree Line. Today I want to talk about my new purchase. It's a Kobalt 80-volt lithium-ion cordless electric chainsaw with an 18-inch bar. It came with in the set with the chainsaw, a 80-volt battery, and the battery charger. Now, it did not come with the bar oil, so I had to buy the bar oil separate. It was $5 for the cord. So what I want to do is I want to put the battery in it. We have a limb down. The reason that I purchased the electric chainsaw instead of a gas-powered chainsaw is that we only have two trees on our property. We have a Bradford pear tree that only loses limbs occasionally, but nothing that would warrant to have a gas-powered chainsaw, which would be more cumbersome than not. You know, the gas would go bad, I'd have a hard time getting it started every time that I needed it, or the little times that I needed it. And then we have a maple tree in the backyard that is, you know, it's just a small maple. So anyway, let me get this thing set up, and we'll go over here. I have a limb down, we're gonna cut that up and see how it goes. So the first thing that we're gonna need to do is we're going to need to get the bar oil, and we're gonna come out here in the grass, and you can probably see in the background my limb that is down. Anyway, so we're gonna put the bar oil in. Now this is just bar and chain oil from ProSelect. I didn't see any for the Kobalt, but there was some for Husqvarna for an additional $2 for the quart. This costs $5. So let's see if I can do this without getting it everywhere. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. That's just a bit much. It's probably gonna make a mess. Now, I will say that the housing's all plastic on this, but it looks to be, we'll see. I'm not gonna give any harsh judgments. Can you? Let's just get this thing ready to go here, and then we'll see how it sounds, what it looks like. We'll run it a little bit, get that off. And let's get that battery. Now, I did have to charge this battery for about 20 hours is what the instructions said, because when I got it, and you can see here the green light showed that it's completely charged. When I got it, it was just it had just one bar charged, and you know, it said to have it running or have it charged completely when you're ready to use it. So the battery just clips down in here, just like that. We'll take the bar off, the bar cover off. Push the button in. And it should beep. There we go. Nice and quiet. So let's go over here and whack away with our new chainsaw. Oh, and I have young Sarah Jane with me running the camera today. Sarah Jane, Mountaineer Sarah Jane. So let's just stroll over here and see how it goes. As you can see, I have this limb down. I lost the limb here a couple of years ago, and I had to cut that thing up with a bow saw, and what a nightmare. So this is probably the last limb that we're going to cut out of this tree, or chop up, because we're probably going to wind up cutting this tree down. So if you would stand back, Sarah, so we can get a good view and you're in the safe distance. And let's see what happens.
You should be wearing eye protection. Yeah, you should definitely do that. Yeah, you should definitely be wearing eye protection. Let's
yes,
go blind.
I should be wearing eye protection.
Probably
but
a helmet.
Not. According, if you read the directions, that you're supposed to. I don't have any eye protection.
Unless you count like a snorkel or something, and.
Yeah, I'm not wearing my snorkel and mask, diving mask. To do this, that would be ridiculous.
Let's go blind.
I look ridiculous on any other given day. I don't need to add to it. So my critique so far is that it's doing everything I thought it was going to do, or what I needed to do. Nice and sharp, but one of the things that I like about it is that it's not loud. So some short opinions right now. I've been cutting for maybe, I don't know, 45 minutes maybe. And the battery is now down to 2 bars instead of 3. And I have a lot of tree to go, a lot of limb to go yet. And the chain popped off. Now, that may be something that I've done,
when I was cutting, I didn't think so. But, so let's see if we can get this thing back going. I removed the battery so there's no chance of it coming on. I'm gonna remove these nuts here. Take this plate off the side. I have to straighten that out. Get this all out of here. I hope you guys can see this. So let's. Now I didn't dirt the chainsaw of the chain any, which means I didn't run it into the ground. So I think if we just put it back together, we should be okay. Now one thing that I don't see is a chain tensioner on here. Like you would see with another, with a, you know, other chainsaws. Let's see if we can get this thing back on here the way it's supposed to go. I might be doing this all wrong, and if I am, sue me. I think this might be in millimeters because my 9/16 wrench didn't fit. Doesn't fit, so seems to be okay. Let's just check the bar oil. Plenty of bar oil. So let's just give it a shot here real quick and put the battery back in. Hit the start button. Seems to be okay. Let's check. See if we can get that a little bit tighter. I wish there was a... Yeah, no, I don't see one. Generally, there's a tightening screw here. You just loosen these bolts. And then turn the screw, but in this case it doesn't have one. Unless this is it here. Oh, yeah. Okay. My ignorance for not. So in between here is a screw. I think that's good there. And we retighten these. Okay. All right, so battery's almost dead. I did get most of the limb cut up. I would strongly suggest if you're gonna buy the Kobalt 80 volt lithium-ion cordless chainsaw that you buy an extra battery, because I mean that's just one limb. If I had planned on taking this tree down, it wouldn't have had enough juice to do it. But I mean, for just lopping up limbs and, you know, maybe cutting some brush and things like that, it does a good job. I'm going to continue testing, and I have some bushes that are growing over into my area that I'm going to cut up. But, you know, and I still have a lot of work here to do with the limbs, but I'm going to have to wait, it looks like, until this thing's charged back up. The chain's nice and sharp. It's really easy to use. It's light. You know, one of the best things about an electric chainsaw is, you know, you don't have to worry about the gas going bad and gumming up the carburetor and not being able to start correctly. So you just don't have that with a cordless electric chainsaw. Now I could have gotten one that you plug in, but you know, I have some bushes back in the back of my property that are growing over that, you know, a cord wouldn't have reached. That's why I went with the corded chainsaw the cordless chainsaw, and I went with the biggest voltage range, the 80 volt. There was some smaller ones, but for the money I paid about $250 for this, and that came with a battery and the charging cord. The battery is like about $100, so I strongly suggest spending that extra $100 and getting the battery. As you can see, I now need to charge the battery. I have one bar left, two bars. It's, you know, since it's been setting, it went back up to two. But, you know, when I'm running it, it's down to one, and that's less than 35%. So, as you see, I still have a lot of work to do. In the meantime, this is Chris in the tree line. I really like the saw. I'm going to continue using it. It's done everything that I've wanted to do so far, you know, with limitations on the battery. But, you have to expect that with any type of cordless electric equipment. So, this is Chris in the tree line. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video.